年纪小的时候，从没想过分别，总觉得时间很慢。可时间在任何时候，有一只看不见的手，
姐，你给我从这儿下来。
它在牵着我们走。
那现在，你们还这么亲密无间吗？
哎，你们凭什么来对我的生活指手画脚的？你们又不是我亲哥。
原来你爸不是你亲爸呀！
我真的不知道你为什么要回来。
那么小就没了吗？真够可怜的。
兄弟姐妹长大了，本来自然就要分开。
那你们从小一起长大的情分就没有了吗？
终于明白，一个人是无法抵挡所有的事情的。
哥，欢迎你们回来。
大家好，欢迎来到看电视学中文，我是文宇。今天我们来一起看一部2020年的热播剧《以家人之名》。热播剧 Hit Drama 家人 Family Members， 这是一部关于亲情和爱情的电视剧。亲情 Family Love， 爱情 Love。If you are new to our channel, we help you to learn Chinese in a fun, easy, and practical way with Chinese movies, TV series, music, news, and other entertaining resources. 点击下方的订阅和小铃铛按钮，不要错过我们将来的课程。Having lost his wife during childbirth, Li 海超ran a restaurant to raise his daughter, Li Jianjian. One day, the woman he dated disappeared suddenly, leaving her son, Zi Qiu, to his family.They soon had new neighbors, Ling's family, but because of losing the daughter in an accident, Chen's wife went mentally abnormal, which drove Chen and his son Ling Xiao away to live on their own. Two men made a decision to raise their kids together. Since then, they lived happily with each other. However, when three kids grow up, Zi Qiu's millionaire father suddenly showed up, while Jianjian and Ling Xiao started to have the chemistry. So,Will the harmony be broken with all of this happening in their family? In today's video, you will get to know a few new words as usual, and also learn some idiomatical expressions in daily speaking. Now, let's get started.
有血缘的不一定能成为家人，但是互相珍惜爱护的人。一定可以。我要宣布事儿啊！
好，
我李尖尖，今天来例假啦！
我要宣布事儿啊！我要宣布事儿啊！宣布。In this expression, 宣 is to speak something in public, and 布 means to publish. So, if someone 宣布 something, they speak or publish it in public, namely announce or declare it. Normally, it is used in formal contexts, like a press or an interview. For example, 昨天他们正式宣布结婚。昨天他们正式宣布结婚。今天来例假了。今天来例假了。来例假。来 is a very common verb in Chinese, meaning to come. Like many other verbs,It can be always combined with many nouns as collocations. 例假 originally means legal holidays, namely public holidays. But in spoken Chinese, it is always used as a euphemism with its extended meaning, menstrual period. So, 来例假 in Chinese referred to have menstrual periods. Question. What is the synonym of 例假 as menstrual period? Trick question. All options are correct. 月经 is a combination of 月, month, and 经, experience. So, 月经 is something that female experience every month. Easy to remember. 大姨妈 and 老朋友 are both other euphemisms for menstrual period.Since in real life, most people catch up with their 大姨妈, big aunties, and 老朋友, old friends, very often, or on a regular basis, these two expressions are then used to represent menstrual period, something females meet with every month.
你们愣着干什么呀？不恭喜我？
恭喜。恭喜尖尖成大姑娘了。
谢谢。
你们愣着干什么呀？你们愣着干什么呀？愣 is a verb meaning to look distracted or to stare blankly. As the aspect particle, 这 is always added after a verb, indicating the continuous state of the action. For example, 站站着吃吃着想想着 Overall, the added 着 means that the action continues for a while, a bit like ing in English, namely the progressive tense. So, 愣着 simply refers to the continuous state of staring blankly. In this scene,Jian Jian's brothers and fathers were staring Jian Jian blankly and got stunned due to her being straightforward and awkward announcement of having her first menstrual period. Let's watch another movie example. 恭喜我，恭喜，不恭喜我，恭喜，恭喜 is an expression frequently used to congratulate others after they hear something good from other speakers. You can use it alone.
恭喜，恭喜，恭喜。
Or place the person plus a positive fact or a good result after the expression.
恭喜尖尖成大姑娘了。
谢谢哥。对了，哥。我送你们的逢考必过红内裤穿了吗？
穿了。嗯。
对了，对了，对 is the Chinese word for correct or right. But 对了 is an idiomatic expression used to mention something when the speaker suddenly remember it. Just like, oh, by the way, in English. Check this example.
顺手多带一本。对了，老师说的参考书，你找着了吗？
我送你们的逢考必过红内裤穿了吗？我送你们的逢考必过红内裤穿了吗？逢考必过 is a modern idiom popular among young people. The direct translation is meet exam definitely pass. It simply means pass every exam attended. 红内裤is an interesting Chinese tradition and culture. As you might have already known, 红 or 红色, the color of red, symbolize good luck and happiness in Chinese culture. That is why ancient Chinese people like so many red adornments and decoration in festivals and ceremonies. So, it is a belief of Chinese to wear 红内裤, the red underpants, to get good luck in important events,such as exams or drive the evil away in the year of someone's animal sign.
检查一下，我还有。
检查完了吗？
可以。
检查一下，检查一下。If you 检查 something, you check or inspect it. 一下。Is a grammatical pattern added after a verb, indicating that the verb is carried out briefly, like a little bit. This helps to soften the tone and make the speech informal. For example, 等一下, 看一下. You can also add it in a separable verbal phrase, namely between the collocated verb and noun. 开门, 看书, 谢谢你们的观看。 如果有更多关于学习中文的问题，或者你有喜欢的中文电视剧和电影，可以告诉我们。我们下次再见。